Hello everyone, welcome to part 8 of my Cliffview project. Last time around, I sorted out a problem I was having with my industrial area, which seems to have been due to an insufficient number of workers. Okay, now last time I tried to start this part, all of my icons down here were bugged, you know, they weren't correct, all messed up. Apparently it's fine now after rebooting. Well, okay, so I constructed this area here last time around. I'm going to complete the roundabout here, since it's the central fixture of the area. To do that, I need to, I need to extend these roads out so I have something to work with, like so, and like so. There we go. Okay, now, how did this go here? I needed, I had a road here, and a road over to here. Okay, so I'll go one more down. I'm using this as a marker here because I have to build curves in here. Now the curves start back about there. Okay, so okay. Okay, so that gives me my marker points. Okay, up like so. And this one needs to go the same angle. But of course, I have to reverse it to go in the right direction. Okay. The real fun comes setting for this side. Okay. So, I'll extend that a bit. So, I need space for the pathway and the zoning space. So that's where my roads will line up here. Okay, now I need to line things up over here. Okay, that gives me my guides, so I can knock these out. Uh, Okay, now I can build my curves here. Like so. And like so. And of course, now I need to set these in the right direction. Right, good. So that gets me my roundabout. Now, I was thinking here, whoops. I really want two lanes through on these legs here. That should maximize the number of lanes that are used going around here. Okay, excellent. That gives me the roundabout, so I'm good there. The reason I've set this up with two lanes through here, and it'd be nice if there was a highway version with only two lanes for this reason, is that as you can see from the arrows on the road surface here, we've got a right turn here, a right or through to here, and a through to here. That means it's more likely that all three lanes will get used. And the same thing here, it's more likely that all three lanes here will get used. I'm trying to avoid forcing everything into the right-hand lane. So that should generally work. Now I'm going to upgrade all of the entrances and exits here. Because this is supposed to be an intersection of main rows, so that seems to be the logical way to do that here. Okay. Ideally, this should be a little bigger, but it should work fine with the traffic dynamics I'm expecting in the area. Now, how far down? Okay, one, two, three, the fourth one. Right, I need a road here. Okay. Okay, so that gives me a linkage there. Now, I'm just going to run the water across here. And I'll just put a little hook here to catch that missing bit. Okay. Now, that gets me my area there with another exit. Now, I also want to, because I'm running these pathways along here, I want to get. Whoop, it needs to be here. And I'm going up just before the. Okay. And I need a. Ramp across here. Okay. Now, why does it do that? Okay. Really? Okay. So that gets me a path around like that. And for completeness, I'll make links in there. Okay. For now, that's probably good. How far back is that? That's going to demolish way back there. Okay. Okay. Right. Okay. Nope, that's not what I want. Okay. So I'm basically setting up an internal park here, a hand-drawn park. So I'll add some trees in here when I'm done. Okay, so I think that's probably reasonable for now in there. I can probably fit one across here. Yeah. There we go. So at some point, I'll run the paths up this side as well. I'm also going to make a connection here. Okay. So that's enough of that for now. I need to add some services in here. How's education? I'm gonna need a elementary school. Yeah, I'm gonna need one of those too. How's health? Health is okay. Put one of these in. A fire station and a police station probably wouldn't go amiss either. Okay, so far so good there. Now I'm going to continue my residential odyssey here. Okay, so there's some more residential spaces. And I'm also going to have some commercial spaces over here. So that should do me fairly well for the moment. So I'm going to speed the game up here and let it run for just a little bit. That clears up the power things there. Oh, bugger. Yeah, I keep doing that, and it's just my own idiocy. So you can see here that the traffic is flowing reasonably well. So while I'm waiting for things to settle out here, I'm going to upgrade that. So that gives me pretty much fast roads all around there, and reasonably good for the roundabout. Now, I can do something semi-clever here. Oh, that's going to break my bridges. Oh, come on, I can't see. Okay. Now, that's fine. Breaking my paths is fine. Breaking my bridges is fine. This maximizes the higher speed road here, leaving just these pinch points, which will force the lane usage that I'm looking for while minimizing delays. No, wrong button. Wrong button again. Okay. I'm going to fix my paths now. Okay. Okay. That fixes that. That fixes that. And that fixes that. Okay. So, I have people running through those, which is kind of cool. So, you can see I've got lots of pedestrian traffic going on these pathways. I was skeptical about that when I was first reading about them, but since then I've become something of a believer in the pedestrian paths. They do seem to work quite well, and they do seem to get well used by the Sims. Okay, so I've got a fair amount of traffic on the highway here, but nothing dangerously high. Okay, so things seem to be working over here. I'm okay with that. What's ultimately going to happen here? Oh, that's a hill. Okay, that's why the road looks funny there. Okay. So what I'm ultimately going to do is bring this area around, particularly the highway here, or the main road. I'm going to bring it around so that it runs into the highway somewhere around here. So I'm going to do that now, as that will inform what I do with the rest of the area. I'm going to start with bringing the highway straight here for a little bit. And yeah, okay. Now, if I leave that on, then I can get a accurate straight bit there. Okay, I'll bring the road across like so. Now, oh, right. I need to do the same thing here. And then I'll curve it. And don't mind the direction I'm dragging, because I'm going to reverse it properly here. Okay, so that brings my road around. Now for the fun part. I need to build my interchange. Okay, now let's see. This is going to have to be a full four-way interchange, I think. So I'm going to start by putting my through lanes over. Okay. There's my through lanes. You can see they're getting closer together as it goes, so I'll have to straighten that out at some point. But now I need to build my ramps. So I'm going to build what's essentially a stacked interchange here. So to do that, I'm going to need to work on curves. Come on. No, it's not going to come across that way. Okay. But that will. Okay, that's one ramp. Nope, I didn't come off far enough back. Okay. Okay, so that gets me two movements. Okay, let's see if I can. Is that high enough? Okay, I had it. Shouldn't need to do that though. I should be able to go straight over. Okay, I'll take those out because that just looks dumb. Okay, I'm gonna try to. There's one direction. And no, that's not gonna go. Well, will that one, will it fit that way? Oh, I can fit one across there. Okay, so if I reverse that one. Good. Okay. Now, okay. 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 Okay, so that gives me a stacked clover leaf, essentially. But okay, now I've got a proper stacked clover leaf. It's a bit tight coming into here, so I may end up doing some funky ramp stuff. So this is great fun. You can do an actual stacked clover leaf with one, two, three, four levels. It looks like a mess. It's probably overkill. I've got a problem here. Ah, yes, I've got the roads going in the wrong direction. Now the question is, why can't I reverse the direction? Why? It's not like it needs to rebuild the bloody road. It just needs to. Okay, so. No, I still can't. Okay. Yeah, that's not gonna work. Okay. Why? Apparently, I'm running into that. Yeah, I was. Why? See, I don't get that. That just shouldn't have been a problem. I should have been able to reverse it. Right, okay. So now I've got all the lanes going in the right direction. Now that's a complete stacked clover. Okay. Oh, that wasn't quite right. Okay. Now I have everything going in the right direction. Okay. So I don't know exactly where I'm going to go with this, but I've built the full interchange there just so that I have it for when I do end up generating some big traffic. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to work in here. I'm going to fill this in a bit like I did over here. So that's down to more grid building, as exciting as that is. Okay. So if you're wondering about that pattern I was using there, it's just an efficient way to. Yeah, I can't do that there. Okay. That was an efficient way to set up the road intersection points. Okay, now I can change this so that I'm actually coming down over here. Come on, pick the. There we go. Okay, so that I think will work. Right. So I'm going to. What am I going to do? Right. I'm going to do some path linkages here. Oh, I need that down at ground level. So, like so. Okay, so that gives me some path links, like so. Right. Okay. Do another row of blocks here, and another row. Okay, that I believe is how I'm going to lay that out. So I need some water in there, which is easy enough. And now I need some other services, probably some education, say over here. And high school's fine. Health is, well, it's okay. But I probably want one of these somewhere over here. Fire is okay. Whoops. Police is okay. So, I'm going to plant a few of these Japanese gardens. And Bob's your uncle, or not. Okay. Right. I'm going to again put commercial along here. And this is going to be residential in the middle again. No doubt some of you are screaming at your monitor saying, don't zone a big block of residential all at once. You'll get a death wave later. Well, I've already got death waves in here, and quite frankly, it's not clear that staggering the zoning makes a particularly huge difference in that effect anyway. So I'm not going to worry about it too much. I'll just deal with it if it happens. Anyway, that. Should give me lots of employees. So I'm going to expand my industrial area a bit as well. Again, with my grids. Okay. Something wrong there when I connect it, so I'm not going to. I'm going to replace this thing here with a different road setup, I think. Yeah, I've got a city limit in the way there. Okay. So I'm going definitely replacing this with a different setup. Okay. Okay. Connect it. Okay. Is I don't think that highway ramps thing was necessary there, given the specific traffic structure that I have there. I'm actually blocking heavy traffic through here, so there's really not going to be a huge amount. That's mostly going to be commuters coming across. So, but I'm not going to overload the area too much all at once with industrial. I think that's an error I've been making all along, is that I've been overloading with industrial all at once and avoiding that problem, I think, will help me with my employment scenario. So I'm going to construct this up slower to avoid that sort of thing, but I'm going to speed up the game here. And let things develop. And hopefully that reduces the chances of messing things up. Anyway, what's my natural resources? Oh, outside connection. So I'm importing 1192. I'm not really exporting anything. I'm importing oil and forest products and agriculture and lots of ore. I think. Nope, and lots of goods. Okay. Now, I haven't gone into the mining business because I've I've read that the deposits don't actually last that long. That may just be some idiocy from the commentators, but I'm not prepared to believe that. So, I'm not prepared to believe that all of the commentators are idiots. And there's been a fair amount of reports of that. Then again, there is a lot of reports that you need uneducated people to work these uneducated jobs. But in fact, your educated people will work these jobs if they're all that's available. So there's really no need to worry about education levels. So it may well be that I don't need to worry so much about resources either if I do decide to exploit them. Now, I could certainly exploit agriculture and forestry without having a substantial problem because those are renewable, so they're not going to run out. But ore and oil do run out, so I'm going to avoid doing that. The thing that's really important is to make sure that your industry levels up. If it doesn't level up, then it produces fewer jobs, for one, and it also produces more pollution. And the higher the level of the industry, the higher the level of education that it will provide jobs for. This one doesn't seem to be getting the workers that it needs. So, this is what I mean by expanding too fast. Well, there's a second worker, but it's got to get them fast, or it's going to end up abandoning. And it needs to get to 50% of the worker total, or it will abandon. So, like the one that just did there. Now, I could potentially have a transportation problem here, but it's up to five, but I don't think it's gonna. It didn't. Okay. So, clearly. Okay, yeah, right. I didn't bring the water all the way out there. Well, that's easy enough. Let's take a look at the bus routes here. I've got one going around. That should be enough of a bus route in the area, given the locations of the metro stops. So that should be okay. So I'm probably running out of actual workers that live close enough or something like that. I should be able to expand in here some more. So as I've got this, if I pick this tile, I can do an end run around and have people able to come in this way, which might help. And of course, it could just be time to get all that sorted out too. But it doesn't look like it. Anyway, I'm not going to worry too much about what's over there for the moment. Because last time I was having issues, it definitely expanding the residential helped. So I'm going to do that. So it looks like I have room for two blocks there before I run into the end of the map. So there we go. I'll build some more grid here. I'll probably need to start building some bus operations in here. bringing the people up to the metro stops. There is some weirdness with transportation in Skylines. It turns out that the Sims carry cars around in their pockets. Or maybe they have a fancy ability called, you know, like a spell or something called summon car, because they seem to be able to produce a car randomly whenever they want to go somewhere, and they didn't have a car in the first place. Which, when you think about it, is quite ridiculous. You know, that's it's a game, and I think they've done that really to avoid making the gameplay excessively complex to the point where only extremely dedicated players would even work out how to play. Education, everything should be okay in there, so I'm going to go ahead and zone some stuff in here. Okay, so that's a bunch of residential there, so that should alleviate some of the issues with worker availability. Now, what's this Zot complaining about? Not enough customers, so building a bunch of residential should help that as well. Now, that is showing, well, it's almost 50% of the workers it needs. Interesting. Will it make it to 100% of the minimum workers it needs? It didn't. Now, it does take a little while for new residential to start providing a decent number of workers. You know, after all, the low density attracts families, which will have primarily will have children. And the children will have to grow up before they can contribute to the workforce. You know, if I was going high density, then I'd end up attracting young adults largely, I believe, and they'll want to go to university, and that also doesn't contribute to the workforce as fast as it might. So, realistically, yeah, it'll help with the job situation, but it will take a while to do so. Now, where have I put metro stations where? They're all over on this side. Okay. So what I'm going to do is plant a bus route or two here, and that means I'm going to want to link up there and I'm going to come across like so. So, and like so, that should bring some of the workers from that area in. To the metro, at least. Okay. It'll certainly make the area more desirable anyway. It made it. That made a difference. Okay. So I'm going to build another one over here. And this one's going to come down like so. And head up like so. So the Sims, as I've determined, are not particularly allergic to walking. So it's not really problematic if the Sims have to walk a block or two to get to their bus. So those should help. So now let's look here in the status here. My bus lines are doing pretty good for saving traffic, so I can't really complain about that. They're all effective to some degree anyway. Okay, bus line 6 has some passengers finally. Okay, and it's actually saving some traffic as well. Okay. Now, I suspect there's less traffic being saved than there might otherwise be because the transportation over in this area isn't so great, and there's a lot of jobs over there. Anyway. Also, the transportation over here isn't as good as it could be. Anyway, let's take a look at the demographics. You see, I have 14% unemployment, which isn't bad, but it's not great either. Demographics aren't too bad, the balance right now. I'm going to expand the industrial a bit here so that there's a little bit more available. As you can see, I'm creating a bit of a traffic jam over here, so I might need to consider some alternatives to the way I have everything set up there. Traffic's moving, but it could be moving better. Okay, so that's probably the number of outlets the traffic actually has here. Now, what happens if if I look in the policies, city planning, if I take off the heavy traffic ban there, I don't think I actually need that there. Does that change my traffic equation over here? Possibly some. I may be able to improve things over there as well by adding an extra ramp here. That does mean I'm gonna have to fix my pathway, though. Okay. Yeah, I don't think that's going to harm anything. Okay, so that may improve things a bit there. And maybe I can bring a. Okay, come on. Maybe I can bring a ramp off the center here. I have to turn. Come on. I have to turn that off to make this work. Oh, you can make U-turns. That's. Oh, hey, come on. I had it. There we go. Here a little bit long. No. No. I think I need to get across here. Okay, let's see if that makes any difference. Yeah, that's going to take some of the traffic anyway. Though it might not be ideal, it's certainly not as bad as it could be. Okay. Now let's see here. Right. Okay. Yeah, that took some pressure off the other the bit up here. So excellent. I'm good with that. Right. Okay. Good. I've got some more industrial demand still building. I'm going to add a couple more blocks of it here. And then we'll see how that goes. I clearly don't need this power line. Okay. I'm just going to fill those blocks in, and I think I'm back up to about the same amount of industrial I started with. It may be overkill, but it should be fine. Well, let's look at the. I'm importing less, okay, so that's good. Okay, so I think I can safely say that I'm in a good spot for well, I'm gonna have some worker issues over there again, but some of that may be transportation, so next time around, I'll try and put a road around here to make it the people here driving, give them a better way in. But otherwise, yeah, because there's a lot of job problems over here. That one sorted itself out for now. But these other ones may not. Okay. Anyway, I'm gonna call that, I think, the end over here. Right, okay, I'm gonna call that. Okay, save the game. Good. Okay. So I'm going to call that the end of part 8, and I'll see everybody back for part 9. Thank you for watching.